大家好，我是戴淑萱，我来自英国，欢迎回到我的频道。今天我想帮大家在说英文时听起来很有学问，很聪明。我总共会介绍十个单词，这些单词我与我的英国朋友讨论过，我们都觉得如果能正确的使用这些词，你会听起来更 fancy。这些都是英国人应该都知道的单词，但不一定是所有的英国人能在日常生活中说出来的，也可能在看文章时你会看到这些单词。第一个是 conduciveTo be conducive of something, or to be conducive to something. This means to provide the right conditions for something to happen. 比如说 the harsh lights and cameras were hardly conducive of a relaxed atmosphere. A loving family and interesting environment are conducive to a child's healthy development. 所以有点像有助于，有帮助于。It's helpful for, it can create this environment.A dark, quiet room is conducive of sleep. 特别是我的话，如果一个房间不黑也不安静，就睡不着，需要有这些条件才能睡得着。所以那就是 conducive of, conducive to, or conducive for something. 第二个是 ramification, 这是一个单词，意思是 consequence or possible results of an action. 通常可能是负面的效果，比如说Have you considered all the ramifications of changing career at this stage in your life? It isn't clear yet what the ramifications of working from home will be. Investing this heavily so soon will have financial ramifications. Financial 与 ramification 是通常在一起的一些词。第三个是 verbatim。Verbatim 的意思是 word for word, 就是 exactly what the original or what they said. I meant to use this template for inspiration.Not to copy it verbatim. 最近我的一个学生真的有问我 verbatim 是什么意思，因为他在英国的同事问他是不是写的 verbatim 还是怎样，是不是 word for word 写下来的。I can't remember what he said verbatim. I can't remember exactly what he said, not every word. It isn't a verbatim transcript of everything that was said during the meeting. 所以应该是大概的一个概括，而不是每个字每个字的写下来。下一个是一个形容词 eclectic, eclectic. Eclectic 的意思是 bringing together many different styles or methods, 经常与 mix 在一起 an eclectic mix of something, 各式各样的各种各样的 It was an eclectic mix of traditional local foods and more exotic dishes. 所以这些东西都在一起呢就创造一个 eclectic mix.This magazine covers an eclectic mix of topics. She had an eclectic selection of objects in her room. So if someone has an interesting collection and they have loads of different things and objects in their room, you could say, what an eclectic mix, eclectic. 然后是 to deviate from the norm, 经常 from the norm 在一起。To deviate, and 意思是 to do something that is different from the usual or common way of behaving. The weather has deviated from the normal pattern for this time of year. Usually if it's sunny in the summer, but then it's raining, torrential rain, 那真是 deviating from the norm, deviating from the usual pattern. Let's not deviate from the topic at hand. 所以如果开会的时候，如果某个人提到一个与我们的主题完全不同的想法，我们可以说 Let's not deviate. Let's not go too far from the existing topic. He never deviates from his strict vegetarian diet. So usually he always eats vegetarian food, and he will never deviate and go a different way and eat meat. Never. He always does the vegetarian diet, and he doesn't deviate from this. It's like to go off path to do something different. 然后是形容词 overt and covert.Overt 是很明显，就是大家看到的东西。比如说 ，He didn't show any overt signs of unhappiness。所以也许他是透透的不开心，但是他没有显示，他没有给大家看这件事，我们不知道。相反呢，我们可以说 covert 就是大家也许感觉到，但是看不到的。There was covert racism in the workplace， 就是不是很明显的。比较透透的，大家感觉到的。还有 overtly 也可以是一个 adverb. She never overtly expressed her feelings about the issue. It was never overtly expressed, so we didn't know that she was how she felt because she never showed it. Her feelings were covert, not overt. 接下来的形容词是 astute. astute， 意思是 to be able to understand a situation quickly and to see how to take advantage of it. So you can really choose how to behave. You're very like clever and wise and precise with your actions and decisions. 就很 astute， 准确。Based on his track records, he is an astute investor. So because he already has made loads of money, so we know that his decisions are wise and thought through, very astute. You make an astute observation there. You make an astute observation, 就是你的观察力很准确。To avoid mentioning that would be astute, in my opinion. 所以就对我来说，我们最好不要提到这个问题。Astute 与 observation 经常在一起。接下来。To err on the side of. To err on the side of something means to lean towards or to prioritize something, perhaps unnecessarily. 10 people have said they're coming, but I've erred on the side of caution and booked for 15 people. 所以我定15个位置是不必要的，但是我想比较小心。So I've erred on the side of caution. Caution 也是经常 to err on the side of 在一起的一个词。It's better to err on the side of generosity than appear too stingy. 所以我们不要让别人觉得我们很小气，所以最好是偏向于太慷慨会比较好。这样 We should err on the side of caution when making this decision. Otherwise, it will backfire. 所以像我一说过 caution 是经常这个偏移在一起的，然后backfire 就是有反效果或者负面的效果。To shoot yourself in the foot 那是 backfire。接下来是 riveting， 这是一个很有趣的形容词，意思是 completely engrossing or exciting， 那就是比 exciting 更 fancy 的一个词，也可以有 extremely interesting 的意思。Riveting, so riveting, extremely interesting. His performance was riveting, so we really enjoyed it. It was really exciting to watch. 那就是很 riveting 的一个 performance. This book was a riveting read. So often it comes with things that we can watch or enjoy like that, like a film maybe. His storytelling was a riveting account of what happened. So it's like when he was telling the story, we were, whoa, so interested and amazed because it was so riveting.这是比较夸张的一个形容词。然后最后的一个是 conspicuously. Conspicuously. This is an adverb, and then we have the adjective conspicuous. 意思是很明显，大家注意到的。It means in a way that is conspicuous, and conspicuous means noticeable, 很明显的 noticeable. They had had an argument, and he was conspicuously absent from the meeting. So it means that him not being there was very obvious.We felt that because there was an argument before, and then the next day, oh, he's not there. Awkward. We notice it. It's very conspicuous. Absence 经常与 conspicuously 也在一起。另外一个例子 ，safety guidelines should be conspicuously placed in all rooms. Okay, because the safety guidelines are very important, so we need to see them. They need to be in an obvious place in every room. Very obvious.也可以有相反的 adverb, inconspicuously means not obvious, like secretly. He entered the room inconspicuously, like he secretly walked in. 那其实 overt 跟 conspicuous 是很像，但是用法不太一样。Conspicuous is more for objects usually, or like one-off incidences, but overt and covert is usually for more widespread kind of phenomenon. 我觉得如果你能正确的说出这些单词，你任何的外国朋友或者同事一定会觉得你是一个很聪明、英文能力很强的人。OK， 我希望今天的影片对你有帮助。如果你喜欢，在下面可以帮我留言，也许我可以再创造类似的影片。谢谢收看，我是戴淑萱，我们下次见哦。